Previously on Ed.
Get out there, find yourself a fine new woman.
I already have.
Then what's the problem?
She's in love with a pompous jackass.
I'm sorry, baby, but I can't go this weekend.
Why?
Got it right.
Doesn't this mean anything to you at all?
So I went to toss him a waffle, like a frisbee. And then at the last minute, I changed my mind and I put it on a plate. I've been with Nick for 7 years.
Hey, babe.
After 7 years, you should be able to toss somebody a waffle, right?
What are you talking about? Go get a waffle, toss it to me, and let's get on with our pathetic lives.
I have to break up with Nick. Done with this.
Carol just broke up with Nick.
You know what? I brought you here tonight for one reason and one reason alone.
To watch you talk to girls.
I know.
To relive my single life vicariously through you.
I know.
Yeah, you know all this. If you continue to sit there not talking to girls.
I know.
Honey, leave him alone.
If I were you, Nance, I'd back me up on this. Otherwise, I might give in a temptation to start talking to girls myself.
You know what, honey? Knock yourself out.
All I was sent to do was to make Xanadu happen.
I don't get it.
Sonny, you have to believe me when I tell you that I never wanted to hurt you. It's
open.
The last thing I wanted to happen.
It's open!
As soon as I appear to you.
When I left this house approximately 24 hours ago, you were watching the movie Xanadu. You are still watching the movie Xanadu. This frightens me. Molly, I just ended a 7-year relationship. I feel I have the right to spend a couple of days watching Olivia Newton-John as a singing, dancing, roller skating muse from Mount Olympus. Okay. Oh. So has Ed asked you out yet?
No. No, he's actually been a real friend during all this.
That won't last. It's only a matter of time before he makes his move.
Molly, Ed is not going to ask me out. He knows better.
For weeks, the only thing standing between me and Carol Vesey is a boyfriend. Now, she breaks up with a boyfriend, where am I? With this smiling goat trying to pick up women.
Eddie, trust me, I'm a woman. I know about these things. Now is not the time to make the move on Carol Vesey.
Okay. All right, I'll wait. For the time being.
Ed, $10 if you go over there and you ask that cute blonde if you can buy her a drink.
That's all you got?
With these beer nuts in your mouth.
Oh, excuse me. I'll buy you a drink.
But here's the thing, Molly. I have to go by his classroom every day after third period in order to get to the cafeteria, and he knows exactly when to expect me, and he always looks up and gives me a wink. You know, it's our little ritual.
So you'd have to go all the way around the building just to avoid his classroom?
Yes, and just thinking about it makes me feel sick.
So don't do it.
You're right. You're right. I can't imagine Nick changing his route to avoid me.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Good for you.
You're right.
Hello, ladies.
Well, hello, Godfrey.
So, Carol, I understand you and Nick have gone your separate ways.
Yeah. Yeah, we have.
Well, as a history teacher, I find I spend most of my time looking at the past. But right now, I see a future for me and you.
Godfrey, that is so flattering. Really, it is. But I've had to swear off dating people at work, you know.
Oh. Well, if you change your mind, I'll be right down the hall.
Thanks. Thanks, Godfrey.
Today, Godfrey Blankman. Tomorrow, Ed Stevens.
Molly, stop.
So what can I do for you folks?
Chuck and I are supposed to get married this Saturday.
Oh, congratulations.
But now we have to cancel the wedding. Show him, honey.
Oh, my.
Well, I brought a picture to my hairdresser of Martha Stewart, and I asked for the Martha cut. This is not the Martha cut.
No. This hairdresser, did she by any chance have any reason to, hate you?
Not that I know of.
She was always perfectly friendly to me.
Look, Mr. Stevens, Chuck and I don't have a lot of money, and postponing this wedding is going to cost us thousands.
So, you'd like to sue?
All we want is what's fair.
Well, it sounds to me like you do deserve some compensation. In fact, you might even have a case against Martha Stewart. I'm kidding.
Oh.
All right, young scholars. Your day of reckoning. Our answering 5 essay questions on the Canterbury Tales. The test will count for 20% of your midterm grade. That is, unless I throw it in the garbage and give you all A's, which I will do under one condition.
What's that, Mr. Stanton?
One of you must say something that moves me, that makes me feel something, anything, I don't care. Make me sad, make me happy. A word, a sentence, a speech, the choice is yours. Just as long as you move me. Any takers, or should I start passing out the tests? Yes, Jessica.
My parents got divorced last year. Ever since then, they've been fighting over me like I'm the car or the house, just another possession. I don't think they know what they're doing to me. Or maybe they just don't care.
No, I'm sorry, Jessica. I'm sure your pain is very real, but it's all just a little too familiar. You're gonna have to dig deeper.
Okay, now, everybody. Now, since I bought this bowling alley, we have turned it into what I believe is Stuckeyville's premier amusement destination. However, we're still not getting as many customers as I would like, so what we need to do is put the word out there that Stucky Bowl is the place to be. Any ideas? Yes, Phil.
Nature's billboard, baby.
Translation, please.
Skywriting. Just imagine Stucky Bowl etched across the heavens. Sends chills down my spine.
Actually, that's not a bad idea. I just think we need
Come on, Bosco. I know a guy out at the airfield, Jack Fundus. Best in the business.
What makes him the best in the business?
The dude crosses his Z's.
Right. Well, I just think we need something a little less temporary, you know? Yes, Shirley.
You weren't supposed to call on me.
Then why'd you raise your hand?
In school, if people raised their hands, a teacher thought they knew the answer, so they would call on someone else who wasn't raising their hand.
Gotcha. Yes, Kenny.
We should get that Where's the Beef lady. She was hilarious. No matter how many times she asked, she never found out where the beef was.
That's so true, man. The location of the beef was always kept a mystery. Well observed, Kenneth. Where's the beef?
Where's the beef?
Where's the beef?
Where's the beef?
Actually, that does give me an idea, though. We could just rent some cheap commercial time in a local TV station, right?
Okay, I'll do it. But I demand final cut.
You'll do what?
I'll direct a commercial.
Phil, you're not a director.
Ed, as the great Jean Renoir once said, I am not a director, I am a storyteller. The only thing I bring to this illogical, irresponsible, and cruel universe is my love.
Yes, Shirley.
Please stop calling on me.
Hey, Cal.
Hey. Hi, I'm just going to meet Molly for lunch.
Oh, great. I'm on the way to the hairdresser's.
Perm, highlights.
Both. No, I have a client who's suing your hairdresser, actually.
I have often wanted to do that.
So how you doing? How are you holding up, you know, post-Nick?
Good. You know. Okay. Bad. Actually, I'd have to say I'm kind of bad.
Oh. Well, I'm sorry to hear that. You know, it's funny, you know, the humans, we're fully evolved. You know, we get the big brains and the opposable thumbs, and we still have no idea how to get over a breakup.
I would gladly trade the opposable thumbs. Frankly, I think they're highly overrated.
But, you know what I think the key is, Carol? Keep moving forward. You gotta keep moving forward. You know, that way you don't spend time sulking and brooding over the break if you keep
moving. I couldn't agree with you more. Really. And that's why I wanted to thank you so much for being such a good friend to me the other night. Really, it's so important to have good friends at a time like this. It really is.
Yeah.
So important.
Absolutely. Yep.
Yeah. Very, very important. I don't know what I would do if I didn't have friends at a time like this. It's just so
important.
So important.
Isn't it though?
So how's your husband?
Hi.
Is he good?
Excuse me, Ramona Barney?
Yes.
My name's Ed Stevens. I'm the legal representative of Lois Cornwall and Chuck Harris. I'm afraid I'm here to serve you with a lawsuit.
For what?
Well, you ruined her hair, Miss Barney. Whether it was accidental or intentional, I don't know.
I gave that woman a perfectly lovely haircut. Made her look like Martha. All she needed was a blue denim shirt and that stupid glue gun.
The haircut I saw bore little resemblance to Martha Stewart.
I cut her hair the way she wanted it.
I find that hard to believe.
Believe me or don't believe me, I don't give a damn.
She's telling the truth.
Who are you?
I'm the shampoo guy.
Mm-hmm.
She made it a little easier than she could have the other day.
Hey.
As kids like to say, what's going down?
Oh, we're just talking about the feeding frenzy at school. All the male teachers are circling Carol like barracudas.
Molly.
Ah, well, that must be nice for you. Have you accepted any dates?
Molly is exaggerating. I think maybe one guy has asked me out.
Who?
Just some history teacher.
Okay, what about Mark Mitchell? He's pretty cute.
Okay. It is very flattering to be asked out. But what you have to understand is these guys don't know me. I think they just, they want to go out with a blonde or something.
My money says she's got a new boyfriend by the end of the week.
Hello, Carol.
Barry. Barry teaches chemistry.
Ah, that's nice. So, Carol, did you happen to know that I'm a member of Club 109?
Club 109? No, what is that?
That's the exclusive fraternity of those of us who've memorized all 109 elements in the periodic table.
That's great, Barry.
Antimony, arsenic, aluminum, selenium, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, and rhenium, nickel, neodymium, neptunium, germanium, iron, americium, ruthenium, uranium, europium, zirconium, lutetium, vanadium, lanthanum, and osmium, and astatine, and radium, gold, and protactinium, and indium, and gallium, iodine, and thorium, thulium, thallium, yttrium, ytterbium, actinium, rubidium, and boron, gadolinium, niobium, iridium, strontium, and silicon, silver, and samarium, bismuth, and lithium, beryllium, holmium, and helium, and hafnium, and erbium, and phosphorus, and francium, and fluorine, and terbium, manganese, and mercury, and molybdenum, magnesium, and dysprosium, scandium, cerium, cesium, and lead.
Excuse me, I'm looking for a Jack Fundus.
That's me.
I'm looking to have something skywritten.
You bet. What are you thinking?
Be mine, Carol.
You romantic.
Say, here's the thing. I've kind of been down the road before with this girl.
You skywrote before and you didn't use me?
No. No, the big romantic gesture. Twice, actually. Didn't work out. You know, once I put on a suit of armor, the other time I made a videotape myself singing for her, and that didn't go so well.
I got my wife.
You see, the first two times, she said no. So this has got to be perfect, you see, because this is it for me. Last shot. Doesn't work, I'm done.
And you're going with Be Mine, Carol?
Yes, sir. Hmm. Wait, what? No, huh? What do you mean? What's wrong with Be Mine, Carol?
No, it's nothing. It's, sweet.
No, what's wrong with it?
Look, I don't want to tell you how to run your life, but, you know, women don't like to be told what to do. I mean, if you tell her, be mine, she's going to resent it.
Oh, well, what do you recommend?
Won't you please be mine, Carol?
Okay, sure, great, okay.
Good. It's $20 a letter. That'll be...
Hold on. I see what's going on here. You're trying to drive up the price by making it longer.
It saddens me that you would suggest such a thing.
I told you. I paid up. I'm off the list.
Mike, this is no good.
Oh, what's no good, Nash?
This sitting here on the couch watching TV. You know, honey, we have a couple of hours a night to enjoy each other's company. We should really try to make it count.
I thought you liked Mannix.
Mike, I'm serious.
Honey, we're so busy all the time. You know, if we're not careful, we're going to wake up one day and just realize that we've just wasted our lives. Honey, we have got to shake it up a little bit.
All right, honey, what would you like to do to shake it up?
I want you to read the first two chapters of this by tomorrow night, and we'll get together and discuss it.
The sun also rises? If I read this, what are you going
to
read?
I'm going to read the same thing. I'll go to the bookstore and get a copy.
Unless we've got like 500 books on our shelves we've never read. You really think we should be getting doubles? I think this could be fun.
So listen, can you come to my noon study hall today? I got some errands to run.
Well, I would, but I can't.
Why not?
Ed Stevens asked me to meet him outside today at noon.
Oh, here we go. The chickens have come home to roost. Time for the big ask out.
God, I hope not.
No, you didn't.
No.
You did not do that.
It's true. It's true.
Oh, so that's why they call it a pommel horse, huh? Derek, you're hysterical. I can't believe that. I'll see ya. Wow. Hi.
Hi.
I found some of your old notebooks.
Oh.
I can bring them in sometime if you'd like.
Sure. I made this for you in the wood shop. It's a bird feeder.
So the hairdresser says you asked for the cut. You say you didn't, so it comes down to he said, she said, except you're both she's, so that makes it a she said, she said.
So how do we prove that we're right?
Well, we need further evidence of the hairdresser's incompetence, basically.
This isn't enough?
No, I think we need to find someone else who got a terrible cut.
Yeah, baby, look at me. Good, keep it real, keep it pure. This is great, Curly. Okay, yes, you have a tragic beauty.
Phil.
Bosco, I'm practicing. Hey, check this out. NYPD Blue. Give me some Sipowicz. Sipowicz! Sipowicz!
You know, I always wanted to go on a stakeout. One of my favorite movies was the movie Stakeout. Even better than that was the sequel, Another Stakeout. They really took it to the next level.
You just keep your eyes glued to that door, and as soon as someone comes out with a bad haircut, you pounce.
Right. I brought coffee.
Great.
I didn't know what size you wanted, so I got small, medium, and large.
Kenny, you could have just brought me a large, and I would have drank as much or as little as I wanted, right?
Yeah, but this way you have a choice. Small, medium, or large.
Yeah, okay. Kenny, The eagle has landed.
Mm-hmm.
Go. Sam.
Excuse me, ma'am.
What do you want?
I'm with the law offices of Edward J. Stevens, Esquire. We'd like you to testify to the incompetence of one Ramona Barney, hairdresser.
Incompetence?
She gave you that lousy haircut.
This is a lousy haircut?
Trust me, ma'am. You look terrible.
Hello.
Hey, Carol. Hey.
So, here we are, 12 o'clock sharp.
There you go. There you are. So, how's school today?
It's okay.
Oh, good. I'm glad. How's the syllabus? Is it?
Well, Ed, you know, it's your basic syllabus.
Is it?
Yeah.
Good. Great. Carol.
Yes?
I know every guy in the world is asking you out right now, but I was wondering.
Ed.
What?
Don't.
Don't. What's the matter?
Oh, I'm so disappointed.
Disappointed? Disappointed in what?
I am having a very hard time, and you of all people should understand what I'm going through. And what do? You decide to come here and ask me out. Is that really fair?
I don't know what you're talking about.
I'm talking about the fact that you came to my house and you made me a sundae. And you told me we were friends, and now it's, oh, forget about what Carol needs. Let's make sure we do what's best for Ed. Ed, you're just like everybody else.
I didn't ask you out.
You were about to ask me out.
I was not going to ask you out.
Oh, really?
That's right.
What were you going to ask me?
I was going to ask you if you needed anything.
Really?
Yeah, that's right. You know what, Carol? I find this insulting. I really do. You know what? I have to go. I'm leaving right now. I'm leaving.
Ed, I'm sorry. I...
Yes, hello. I need to speak to Jack Fundus immediately. Now, I know he's in the plane. Just tell him it's an emergency. Fundus, listen. You have to stop skywriting immediately. No, wait. Actually, that's too obvious. Here's what you do.
Carl.
Oh, hors d'oeuvres.
This is already better than college.
Okay. Why don't you start?
Me?
Yeah.
Okay. How do I do that?
Well, what did you think of the first two chapters?
The first two chapters of The Sun Also Rises.
Yeah, yeah. What'd you think?
Well, they were, yeah, they were good.
Yeah, but why? How? Let's talk about the characters, the symbolism, Jake Barnes, Robert Cohen, Spain.
Spain, yeah. Well, I believe that Ernest Hemingway was trying to tell us that the sun, in addition to setting, also does other things.
Right.
And also, Ernest Hemingway loved bullfights. He couldn't get enough of bullfights. Yeah, he went all the time.
Yeah.
Yeah, and machismo. He really loved machismo, you know. Bullfights and machismo.
Bullfights and machismo.
Oh yeah, oh yeah. If you gave Hemingway some bullfights and a little machismo, he was a happy, happy man.
Did you read any of these two chapters?
Yes, I did, Nance.
I mean, recently, like not in high school?
Nance, I don't have time to read.
That's great, Mike. Okay, you know what? You're not taking me seriously.
Nance, what about Mariel Hemingway? She was in Star 80. Discuss that.
Okay, Kit and Coco, I need you guys to scooch together a little bit more. Well done. Now arch the back. Splendid. And I think we're ready to try one. Moisture!
Thank you. You're very tall.
And action.
Stucky Bowl is the hottest place to bowl.
So hot.
That's why we bowl here all the time.
With all our hot friends.
So, if you come...
Cut! 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 Cut. Coco, love, it is not with all our hot friends. Remember, it's with all our super hot friends. Right? Trust the page, okay? Just fall back and let the words catch you. Perfect. Let's go again. This time, maybe a little lip action together just a
Excuse
bit.
Me. Hello, ladies. Phil, may I have a word with you?
Bosco, I'm really under the gun here.
Phil? I don't want strippers in this Ducky Bowl commercial.
Why?
Because Stucky Bowl is a family place. It's a nice place. It's not a stripper kind of place.
Okay, Bosco. You and I are having some serious creative differences here, but hey, you're the boss. Ladies, thank you very much. We're going in a different direction. Kenny will validate your parking. You're breaking their little stripper hearts.
I know.
Hi.
Hi.
I brought your notebooks.
Thanks.
So, how are you doing?
You wanna know how I'm doing?
Yeah, I do.
I'm great, Carol. Couldn't be better. 7 years of my life were just incinerated and tossed to the winds. Feels good. Feels great. Why are you here? What do you want from me?
I thought maybe we could be...
Be friends?
Yeah,
maybe. Or at least talk. I mean, it feels so strange to go from being together for so long to not even being able to say a word to each other. You know?
You know, Carol, there's something girls like you never understand.
Girls like me.
You have cake. When you eat the cake, there is no more cake. You can't have the cake and eat the cake.
I see.
You got plenty of friends. I got plenty of friends. This right here was never about friendship.
Hi, honey. Sorry I'm late.
No, no, that's okay. Hi.
Honey, this is Professor Kaplan.
Professor Kaplan? Hello, sir.
Professor Kaplan's here to teach us Einstein's theory of relativity.
Then why is that, honey?
Well, honey, I was thinking it would be a new and different way to spend the evening, and I found Professor Kaplan here at the community college, and I think it's time that you and I learned Einstein's theory of relativity once and for all.
All right, I'm game. Let me just shut off Baywatch Y here. Okay, I'm ready.
Is there anything I can get you before we get started?
Got any grapes?
Sure. Sure.
Now, these photographs were taken of customers leaving here today. However, none of these women were willing to testify that they received a bad haircut.
What about this girl? Her hair looks like it's been twisted into knots.
That's a French braid, Chuck. Very stylish with young people today.
Yeah. So what can we do?
Well, I'm going to put you on the stand, Lois, and you'll just tell the judge what happened.
But won't Ramona just say the opposite?
Probably, but it'll be our job to convince the judge to believe you.
How do we do that?
I'll just ask you to say what happened, and you just tell the truth.
Using the Lorentz transformation, we can replace the space-time variables x, y, z, and t of the Galilean reference body k with the space-time variables x prime, y prime, z prime, and k prime.
Well, I think we're in pretty good shape here. So I'll give you guys a call tomorrow, and I'll tell you what time you need to be in court.
Thanks, Ed.
Okay.
If you're as good a bowling alley operator as you are a lawyer, then I'll bet you're a very good bowling alley operator. You know, assuming that you're a good lawyer.
Thanks, Chuck. Good night. Kenny, I'm not here.
Gee, that's a tough one.
What?
All right, give up.
Kenny, what are you talking about?
Isn't that one of those brain ticklers, you know?
Kenny, listen to me. I just saw Carol in the parking lot, okay? We had this big fight the other day when I went to the school to do the whole skywriting thing. I don't feel like seeing her right now. It ended up being a little embarrassing, okay?
No problem, boss. You know, I always liked that brain tickler where the doctor is the kid's mother.
Hi, Kenny.
Hello, Carol.
Is Ed around?
Ed? No.
Do you know where he is? Kenny.
Buenos Aires.
Thank you so much, Professor. That was really fascinating.
Well, I hope you understood everything.
Hey, everything's relative, right?
Well, actually, if... By that you mean...
No, I was kidding. I totally get it. E equals mc squared. It's genius.
Well, all right.
Bye-bye.
Great evening, honey.
Please, Mike, if I didn't keep nudging you, you would have fallen asleep.
Nance, I couldn't understand a word the guy said. Could you?
No, but at least I tried, Mike. You know, at least I am attempting to not waste what limited time we have on this planet sitting on the couch doing nothing. God, Mike. We're going to be 80 years old and not have any stories to tell our grandkids.
Gather around, kids. Grandmammy and Grandpappy are going to tell you about Einstein's theory of relativity.
They're That is not the point, Mike, and you know it.
Lance, I didn't mean to... I just thought it'd be fun to say Grandpappy.
Well, Kenny, when Ed gets back from Buenos Aires, was it? Tell him I stopped by.
Sure thing.
Bye-bye.
Oh, how'd you like the Skyrider?
Skyrider? Ed did that?
You didn't know?
No. No, I didn't know until now.
Didn't know what till now?
Okay, Kenny. Nice try.
I don't know anything about any Skyrider. I was just making conversation.
Carol knows that I was the one that got the Skyrider.
It's unclear.
Right.
Shirley?
Ah, the commercial.
It's really good. I love it. It is the best commercial that I have ever seen. Except for maybe the one with the black guy with the deep voice who used to say, these are cola nuts.
Shirley, those who raise the bar of expectation bar the expectation of raise.
Hey, that makes... No, that doesn't make sense.
Shall we watch?
Please.
Hi, Dad.
Hi, son. Big day today, huh?
Yeah.
Here, let me get that for you.
Thanks.
I still remember the first time I taught you how to tie one of these.
You've taught me a heck of a lot more than that, Dad.
I'm proud of you, son.
I love you, Dad.
I love you too, son.
Stucky Ball.
Who's the man now? Who the man now?
It's very moving. But does it have anything at all to do with a bowling alley? Or bowling at all, even?
Yeah. Didn't you hear at the end where it goes, Stucky Bowl?
Right. Hey. Hi.
Hi. Can we chat?
So, where's Chuck?
He's at work.
No, really? What's he do?
He imports bauxite.
Really? Bauxite.
It's a cutthroat business. It's not what you know, it's who you know.
Hmm. Is that right?
Ed, I can't go on the stand.
Well, listen, Lois, what you're feeling, those are just pre-trial jitters. It's natural. Everybody gets them. I get them. You'll be fine.
It's not jitters. The reason my hair looks this way is because I told Ramona to keep cutting.
Oh. Oh. Lois, do you want to get married?
No.
Oh.
I'm not sure. I mean, Chuck's a great guy. Mm. You know, I'm afraid to take the plunge.
Lois, this might not be my place, but can I offer you some non-legal advice?
Sure.
I don't really know you. I don't really know Chuck. But if you're going to get married, be sure. Don't just do it and hope it works out.
Mommy loves you.
Lady, get up out of that chair. Tonight you and I are doing something we've never done before.
What?
We're making frites, Nancy.
We're making French fries?
Frites, Nancy, frites. These crazy Belgians know how to live. I'm shaking it up, man.
You hiding from me?
I'm fixing some equipment.
Oh, please, Ed. I know that you were avoiding me last time I came here.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Come on, Kenny's not that good a liar, and he told me about the Skyrider.
All right, fine. And you're here because?
I feel like I just had the same conversation with Nick.
Yeah, I'm actually really kind of busy here.
Sorry to waste your time, and thanks for all your help there, Ed.
You're angry at me? You're angry? Why are you angry at me?
Why are you angry at me?
Because I show up at your school and you immediately assume I'm there to ask you out. That's arrogant. You're arrogant. It must be nice to be that arrogant.
You were planning to ask me out.
You didn't know that. You did not know that, and yet you immediately assumed it. What kind of person assumes something like that? You know, that's, it's incredible, you know? It's really, it's just unbelievable.
Ed, you showed up in my classroom in a suit of armor to ask me out. You made a video of yourself singing to ask me out. I break up with my boyfriend. I don't think it's a crazy assumption to think you might ask me out again.
You know what, Carol? When you assume...
Assume nothing. I was right. You were going to ask me out. You hired a skywriter.
Fine. I hired a skywriter. Forgive me. I hired a skywriter to ask you out. Oh, of all the horrible things to do to someone.
You're not thinking clearly.
No, Carol, I wasn't thinking clearly, okay? You said so yourself. This was never about you. It was because I was messed up over a divorce. Well, I did something impulsive and stupid. Very stupid.
You're arrogant.
I'm arrogant? I'm arrogant?
Yeah.
How am I so arrogant?
You're
How am
arrogant.
I so arrogant!
You're the one who was arrogant because you pretend to be Mr. Lovable Nice Guy, and you're not. You're not! In reality, you come into town and you tell me, Carol, you're in the wrong relationship. You don't know me, but I'm Ed Stevens and I'm adorable. What kind of person assumes that?
You know what, Carol? You don't have to worry about that ever again, okay? Because the days of Ed Stevens putting on suits of armor and hiring skywriters and making videotapes to ask out Carol Vesey are over. They are so over, and you never have to worry about that ever again.
Fine.
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 I am leaving now.
I'm fixing a bowling pin setting machine.
Ed, 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 young, innocent Ed.
Hi, Nick.
I can see it in your face. She's got you, doesn't she?
Who?
Carol. Man, you are in for the ride of your life.
What are you talking about?
Fly high, Icarus. But don't you get too close to the sun.
I'm not understanding a whole heck of a lot of what you're saying here.
One day, you will.
Duncan, I believe we have a tradition here at the Smiling Goat.
That we do. The three questions! A man has come before us today with a broken heart. Let us go about mending it. First, how much do you love her?
This is the girl that swirls around inside of you. Sometimes she robs you. Sometimes she fixes you. But always, she moves you.
Next, how much do you miss her?
Just like that. All the colors are gone. The world is black and white now, with just a few shades of gray to remind me of what it used to be. Yeah!
And last, how much better off will you be without her?
What's the happiest day in a man's life? The day he meets the girl.
What's the happiest day in a man's life? The day he's free again. What's the happiest day in a man's life? The day he meets the girl. What's the happiest day in a man's life? The day he's free.
Ed's not here.
Come on, Carol. Come with me.
What?
Just come.
What are you doing?
Come on, don't ask so many questions. Come on. Hurry, come on, we're late.
Where are you going?
Okay, here.
What?
Look up. Ed, I can't afford to lose you as a friend now.
I don't think I could afford that either.
Let's face it. We have been through a lot together. Nick and Liz. Bowling alley purchases.
Yeah, right.
We're not ready for each other.
I know we're not.
I don't want to make another mistake right now. Do you?
No. I don't want to make another mistake either. So what do we do now?
We agree to be friends. Good friends. For real this time, once and for all.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Now that we're friends, you know what we should do?
What's that?
I really think we should have a sleepover.